elderly or more vulnerable people in our community. Residents of a town in Devon have had a system operating for some years. Every street in Ilfracombe is covered by a network of volunteers. John Kay went to find out how it all works.
Self-isolation will not silence him. Ilfracombe's town crier might be confined to his doorstep, but he still has a message to deliver.
Stay safe, my friends. You know it makes sense.
It's certainly different.
Out of his robes and tricorn hat, 84-year-old Roy joined me for a video call. It sounds like everybody is coming together.
Ilfracombe is absolutely brilliant. We have a really fabulous community spirit. Normally, you've only got to ask and it is done. We are very, very fortunate.
Ilfracombe is a seaside town. Many of its 11,000 residents are elderly and vulnerable and will need protection in the weeks ahead.
Bicklescombe Park, I've got 3 volunteers.
And this is how they're doing it. Before they had to start working from home, we filmed at the offices of One Ilfracombe, a pioneering project bringing the council, NHS, emergency services, charities and businesses all under one roof. Working together, they've been able to organise an army of volunteers.
What we've done is tried to break it down into these kind of bite-sized areas, so they become kind of their own micro-community. So they all start looking after each other. They're all communicating through Facebook.
After a shout out on social media, 150 people came forward to act as street coordinators, going door to door, leafleting every household, offering help.
You always know that you live in a fabulous community, but it's when things like this happen that you really sort of start understanding, and you get the goosebumps when you feel that everybody's coming together to really help each other out.
So even though the town is shut down, every single street is now covered by a volunteer, and communities across the UK are watching to see how this North Devon community is pulling together. Take Mel. Her gardening and cleaning jobs have stopped because of the crisis, so now she has a new role.
Oh, fantastic.
I managed to get everything that you needed.
She's one of the volunteers, shopping and collecting medicine for people like 86-year-old Mo, who lives alone. It's hoped every single person will now get the help they need.
I don't know what I would do without the volunteers. Absolutely fantastic. Otherwise, I would not have anything.
I started thinking about the people in my community who are vulnerable, who are elderly, and who might slip through the cracks as this whole drama unfolds.
Of course, these are still early days. No one knows how long this crisis will go on for or how badly a town like Ilfracombe may be hit. The nearest A&E department is half an hour away. But for now, at least, the community response is giving confidence and hope.
When this is all over, I want to see all of you. And then we will party! God save
John Kay, BBC News.
Now, if you're not out and about volunteering, how are